Tailless answer to the call issued by the aeronautics director of the Department of Commerce for a flivver of the air.
It is my hope that someday that this little ship will become the great-great-granddaddy of America's air flivver.
Just a pair of wings and a place to sit, and what a place. The tiny craft weighs 1,100 pounds and has a wingspread of only 30 feet. A device on the wingtips controls direction.
Meet the professor, folks. For 20 years, he's been watching the Killeluberg and has finally discovered what makes it fly. All it takes is a tank full of oxygen, a left-handed monkey wrench, and a couple of nuts. Here we go. History in the making. It's the happiest day of the professor's life. Let's hope he's put salt on its tail. Going, going, that's all.
Something new to make flying safer. Stabilizers like these keep the plane level while in flight. The pilot's taking up the ship to show you how the device works. There he is, getting out of the cabin, leaving the plane completely under automatic control. See how smoothly it flies, without a human hand to guide it. Now the pilot's on the fuselage, and no one is in the cockpit. The test is a success and should encourage one-armed drivers who want to hug their girls.
More convincing proof of the amazing and rapid progress of aviation you wouldn't want, I'm sure, than this demonstration at Baltimore today. J. Carl Bauer and Lewis Huber went to work in their spare time to construct this poor man's dream, a plane propelled by bicycle pedals. It's a momentous occasion. All aviation stops to watch. Did someone say they laughed at the Wright brothers? Well, this pair will try again, too. Maybe make a bicycle out of airplane parts.
Paris offers a real novelty in aircraft. It's called the elytroplane, and it's based on the principles of a flying mosquito with the sting left out. Its tail sticks up in the middle and is supposed to prevent slips and nosedives. Now we'll see what we will see. It works. The brainchild of inventor Vicomte de Rouge speeds 60 miles an hour. For 5 years, the Vicomte has been laughed at. But now, it is he who has the laugh.
Folks, here I am with a new device called the Ornithopter. This device, I expect to attain flight in the air. Through a system of leverage advantage, plus a man's physical power, I believe it possible to fly as a bird. And here I am. You can look this device over. It appears heavy. It's light.
Well, that sounds okay if it works. But if Bertie doesn't fly when he makes that jump, he's going to get a real cold bath. Here he goes. Splash-o. Well, he got the bath all right. But is little Willard discouraged? Not a bit. Just wait a moment and you'll see. Now his feathers are all dry again. He's had a good dinner of canary seed, so maybe this time he'll really do it. He's going to soar gracefully off the rock, so he says. Keep your eye on the birdie. Cuckoo, cuckoo.
Here you see another type helicopter or direct lift air machine. Our principle, as you will see, is a flat plate or disc type propeller moving the air fast enough to produce a lift. Our engine is connected to our transmission by a jack shaft driven by a chain. Our transmission rotates and reciprocates our propeller. As the propeller goes up, we get our lifting power on the down reciprocation.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll show you how this works.
The plump chap there is a butcher by trade, but in his spare moments, he's a student of aerodynamics. And right now, he's demonstrating in a small way the principle of a new rocket device he's working on. Oops! Something must have gone haywire.